Hey, what's up everybody, it's your Oh no, Premiere, not again! Dude, I'm on a Mac M1! This is a PC error message! Adobe Premiere has lots of bugs. You know that already. Today, we are going to learn an essential solution to stop crashes, speed up and back up your big projects. If you are working with high resolution 260 videos or big feature film project shot on RAW like R3D, Blackmagic RAW or ProRes, you realize that your project is getting slower day by day. Getting rid of unused footage, collect, clean up and reorganize video with the Premiere Project Manager are usually the only solution. But the project manager does not always work. It fails for unknown reasons, especially for 260 video project with lots of After Effects dynamic link composition and red R3D RAW file. So, I found an alternative solution that will help you to do less this. Premiere Video Editors. If you want to improve your live quality in general, let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the YouTube channel that dedicatedly helps video editors to sleep better at night. If you want to sleep better at night as well, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell right here. Besides speed up slow Premiere project and stop random crashing, project management have practical reason as the best practice as well. Reason number one, save storage space. SSD hard drive is very expensive. Shooting in RAW or 260 VR, video files tend to get really big. After your clients log your edit, you want to keep only the portion of the video that used in the sequence and get rid of the extra heads and tails without transcoding your media or losing RAW metadata. See right here, a project shot in two red kimono in VR180 with R3D and ProRes source file. The original project size is 468GB and the resulting project size will be 314GB.
Wow!
If you save more than 100GB in size, that is without trimming the RAW video. With the software I will show you, it will be 226GB. Almost half the original project size if you save you lots of money in buying extra SSD storage. Reason number two, sending project for collaboration. If you work in a team, it is common to package your project and hand it over to another team member for reason like VFX, 260 stitching, coloring with the RAW files, ambisonic sound design, and etc. Reason number three, better file organization in one place. Big feature film projects usually have lots of files spread across multiple network drives. Collect them locally in one SSD can help increase editing speed and minimize errors. If you did not learn all that in film school, at least you learn it now. So go to File, Project Manager, and optimize your project like so. As I mentioned it earlier, Premiere Project Manager is not reliable. So I use this tool called Plum Pack by Autochroma, the same developer of After Codecs and Braw Studio. Compared to Premiere Project Manager, Plum Pack will handle nested sequence and copy over After Effects dynamic links composition dependency. It won't put everything into a same folder like the nightmare that Project Manager created. It will actually organize your files based on your bin structure inside your Premiere project window. It will copy over additional files associated with your R3D or Blackmagic RAW files. It will trim your media without transcoding, so lighter backups and faster transferring. Let me show you my workflow now.
Okay, after installing Plum Pack,
If you don't see this window, go into here, extension, and it should be right here. You turn this on, and it's a panel, right? You can dock it anywhere you want. You should dock it right here. And then feel free to go over documentation, but it's very straightforward. So here is the entire project file shot with the red kimono. It's our PPC, Fox PPC project right here. It's a professional project, but now it's done. I want to archive it, right? So right here, disable trimming, meaning that will just be copy only. But if you don't want to trim, you can just turn this off. Now it's just copy only. That is the same feature as the Premiere Project Manager right here. It's the same setting. Why not? If you check this, but let me uncheck that. I actually want to trim it to give myself more space. So in here, it's very important. You can have handle before and after your source video right here. Industry standard in VR is 30 frame, meaning that 1 second before and 1 second after head and tail. And you want to have some headroom in case you want to move footage, in case you want to do future edit, you at least have 1 second to move around. So here is a kind of important option right here, drop meta streams if necessary. So for 360 video, they usually have a 360 meta, but it will be all right. You don't need to keep that, because even you lose that, you can still go back and sequence setting right here. Let me just actually set a sequence in sequence and sequence setting, and you can get this medium back, and also you can get it back into I did not use it here, but you can also get it back in a VR projection right here. Just for example, VR projection. And you can tell, you can turn this like auto VR thing off and tell Premiere that it's a side-by-side stereo project. And output is also side-by-side. If you lost the meta, it's not a big deal. So that's why I always check this. Because when you check it, you go ahead and trim the VR media as well. This is important. I always check that to clean up my project. And this, if you want to deal with the nasty sequence, so here we don't have any nasty sequence, so we'll keep it unchecked. Then we go ahead and analyze the project. And Plumpad, we go ahead and do it on the background. While they're doing the analyzation, you can actually continue doing your editing. You don't need to wait for Plumpad to do it. This happened in the background. It had a really cool feature. It's background processing. Okay, now the analyze is done and will give you a report to tell you what is going on. So Plumpad will save you almost half of the size of the entire project, 200 gigabyte. This usage you can say on this project, that's very, very significant. You can drill down here to see what is going on, what media being trimmed. And as you see, when you trim, it also add the frame number into your file name. That's really useful when you're using like Mystica VR to stitch. In case you want to change the entire source file, you can go back here and using this number to get the exact same stitch called online stitch, so you don't need to stitch extra footage. So this number is also a benefit of using Plumpad. So you see the full report right here to see what is going on. So after that, you can go ahead and hit the consolidate project, and Plumpad will go ahead and trim everything and reorganize everything for you.
Thank you for watching. I hope this helped you sleep better at night and save you some money on hard drive space. Hey, don't forget to give me a thumb up and help me sleep at night as well. If you are new here, it will help me a lot if you consider subscribing to our channel and hit the notification bell right here. And I will see you in the next tutorial or in my upcoming VR filmmaking masterclass right here. Maya Angelou famously said, "People will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you make them feel."The ability to make your audience feel love or hate, joy or despair, fear or enjoyment had never been more at our fingertips than now with virtual reality 360 storytelling. If you have ever wondered how to make a film, documentary or fictional piece using this new medium that creates an emotional impact, a feeling that they will never forget, then please come join me, as it is my mission to give you this power to touch, to inspire and to create. In this 360 VR filmmaking masterclass, we will give you a framework to work from as a storyteller or filmmakers using your familiar language. No matter what your skill level is in immersive production, you can take away a wealth of knowledge from some of the world's leading experts in the field. We will cover practical topics like fundraising, client communication, budgeting, scripting and storyboarding, directing, blocking, set and space design, camera and shooting, lighting, spatial audio, DIT, stitching and editing, and even distribution in the entire VR filmmaking ecosystem. I hope this course will serve as your go-to guide on VR filmmaking, so you can go out there and create. No matter if you are a VR producer, director, camera operator, or VR enthusiast.